Welcome to this video introduction to Tito, designed to get you up and running with your first event in around 5 minutes. The very first step is to sign up for a Tito account. Head to ti.to and click Get Started. Complete our short form, enter your email address, and then check your inbox for our confirmation email. Once you've confirmed your email, you'll be prompted to enter your full name and a password. Now, let's get started. I'm going to skip uploading a profile picture for now, although I can do this later if I like. I am going to set my time zone now. Next, I need to give my account a name. This should be something generic, like my company name. The idea is that all my events can sit under the same account, so I won't include anything too specific, like the location or the year, as this might change. I'll set my VAT status here, and I can change this later if I need to as well. And my account has been created. Let's create a first event as a test to complete the process. And I'll click Done for now. What I want to do next is invite my colleagues. If I head to Account Settings and select Team, I can either add people to the admin team and they'll automatically have full access to all the events, or I can create another team and give them limited access to specific events. In either case, I just need to enter my teammates' email address to invite them. Now that my team is set up, let's create a new event from scratch. I'll choose the correct account if I have access to multiple ones and enter the event name. Now let's make some simple customizations by uploading an event logo, setting the date and location, and changing the public contact email address. If you click on this icon at the top of the dashboard, you'll open up the event homepage. This is the bit the attendees see. Already we've started to populate the main information, but let's make it look even better. Head to the Homepage tab under the Customize menu and you can upload a banner and add some additional information. Now, if we refresh our event homepage, we can see it's starting to have a lot more personality. We can also add a map under the Location menu. Now let's set the event currency and attach our payment gateway of choice so we can actually process ticket payments. Tito supports Stripe, PayPal, and a few others. I'm going to go with Stripe. I simply log in with my Stripe account, and I'm all done. I need to charge VAT on tickets for my event, so now's a good time to set up a tax type which I can then attach to tickets. Again, you'll find this option under the Customize menu. Just scroll down and click on Tax. Click on Invoicing to add your company details, and these will automatically appear on the receipts that Tito generates for this event. Now we should probably add some tickets. We can enter the ticket name, quantity, and price inclusive of tax and hit Save. We can also continue editing to add further details like order limits if we need to. Tito gathers basic customer information like name and email by default, but if you'd like to ask your own questions, you can do this using our data collection feature. Create a custom question, specify what type of question it is, and be sure to attach it to the relevant tickets. We're almost ready to go live, but it's a good idea to test everything first to make sure it looks right. You'll find this option under the Customize menu again. We provide some fake credit card details that you can use to put through test transactions without any charges. Once you've enabled test mode, you can head over to the event homepage and put through a transaction as though you were a customer. Okay, we've tested our event and we're happy with everything. It's time to go live. All you need to do is head to the dashboard and flip the switch. I hope you found this Getting Started video useful. If you have any questions or you need help getting set up, email us at support@tito.io.